Welcome. This is Information Service Engineering. This is lecture number 6, Knowledge Graphs. Today, we are entering a new chapter of the lecture and we will talk about knowledge graphs. So what are knowledge graphs? In knowledge graphs, we want to represent knowledge, not only information, real knowledge. And because of that, we have to talk about how to represent knowledge. And before we talk about how to represent knowledge, of course, we have to ask, what is knowledge? We will see that knowledge can be defined on terms of philosophy. So philosophy has, targeted this kind of question already for a long time. And of course, we can make use of philosophical research that has been performed and, of course, of all the knowledge that is out there to come up with a knowledge representation. However, if we want the machine, the computer, to understand these kind of knowledge representations, they have to follow a, formal framework, which is in our sense, most times mathematical logic. So to become understandable, and you remember that we have talked about understanding information also in the natural language processing part of this lecture, also, the machine must be able to understand this knowledge representation, which means, you remember, it has to interpret it correctly in an automated way. And how to do that and how to explicitly model semantics, model knowledge, you will see here in the very first chapter when we are talking about knowledge representation and ontologies. However, we need languages to express these kind of knowledge representation, these ontologies. And these languages have been defined for the semantic web and the web of data. So what is the semantic web? This is an extension of the current web where all pieces of information is given explicit meaning. So the meaning is explicitly modeled and represented there so that we can make use of it in an automated way and that machines are able to understand, which means to correctly interpret the meaning of what is represented there. How this works in principle, you get a first overview in the second chapter of the lecture. Today, one of the most important, outcomes of this semantic web initiative is linked data and linked open data, which forms the core of the web of data. And you will learn about the principles, how to organize your data as linked data, and what does it take that structured data becomes linked data on the web. And for that, we are talking about the simple linked data principles. And after that, we are going to look deeper into semantic web technology, which means we are looking into the semantic web technology stack. And we start right at the bottom, where we are talking about how to identify and to access things. So this is ground laying. Of course, if you want to make a statement about something, this something is not necessarily on the web. So if you want to make a statement about a real thing in reality, of course, this is not on the web, but you need a reference on the web for that. And it works to take exactly this kind of reference instead of the real object. You will see how this works then in the last part of the lecture when we are going to talk about URIs and how to identify and access things in the semantic web and the web of data. Okay, these are the first 4 chapters in Knowledge Graphs 1. I hope you enjoy them. Now relax, sit back and watch.